Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. You know, a lot of times at Fun Science Demos, we like to say that science is all around us. We just have to take the time to stop and see if we can find it. Well, we wanted to try something simple and see if we could find the science that's at work behind it. What is that something simple? Well, it's something that most kids have either seen or done before. It's painting with watercolors. So I'm going to start with some blue, and I'm going to try to paint the ocean. Now, some of you may have noticed that when it rains, that water is fresh water. It doesn't taste salty at all if you were to taste it. It's not like the water that you find in the ocean. The water in the ocean, if you ever taste it, tastes salty. You can't drink it. Well, what a lot of people don't realize is that the water that comes from rain, much of it actually comes from the ocean. Stop and think about that. The water that comes from rain is fresh water. I can drink it and it doesn't taste salty, but if it comes from the ocean, something has to happen to take the salt out of it. Well, that's the science that's at work. And believe it or not, that same science that takes the salt out of the water in the rain is the same science that's at work in my watercolors. So now I have my ocean, I want to dip into some yellow, and I want to paint something very important in my picture. The thing that I'm painting is the thing that makes all that science of taking the salt out of the water happen. So I'm painting the sun, and the sun is what takes the fresh water out of the salty ocean. So how does that happen? Well, to answer that question, I'm going to dip into some red. And the red's going to show us that heat energy from the sun beats down on the top of the ocean. When that heat energy from the sun heats up the top part of the ocean, that liquid water in the ocean turns into a gas. And scientists call that evaporation. Remember, when the water from the ocean evaporates, it's only the water that evaporates. All of the salt in the ocean is left behind. Believe it or not, the same science of evaporation is at work in our watercolor painting. Take a look at the ocean that I just painted. It's totally dry. The water on our painting went away. It evaporated. It turned to a gas, and what was left behind? The color was left behind. But if the water went away, where did it go? So where does all of that water go once it evaporates? Well, that water turns into a gas and we can't see it. All the air around us right now has water in it, but we can't see it because it's in the form of a gas. When that invisible water vapor gets high enough and cold enough in the air, it can form a cloud. And what can come from clouds? Pure, fresh rainwater. It's a cycle. Scientists call it the water cycle. Well, here at Fun Science Demos, we came up with our own special recipe of lickable watercolors. That's right, you can lick them. And it better helps to explain evaporation. And believe it or not, we're going to share it with you. So the color in our watercolor paints comes from food coloring. We decided to put salt in the blue food coloring to give a salty flavor, and we decided to put citric acid in the green to give a sour flavor. You're gonna notice as I paint this on, I can't see the salt at all. I can see the blue coloring, but I can't see the salt. Just like when I put the green on, I can't see the citric acid in the green. The only way I can tell if the salt or the citric acid is there is by tasting them. For this next part, you're going to need an adult and some safety glasses. So to make our lickable watercolors, we have to start by heating up some water. It doesn't have to be a rolling super hot boil, just heat up some water. Next, I'm going to add some food coloring. In this case, I'm going with red. You can make it any color you want, and you're going to want to put a lot of the food coloring in. Otherwise, when you paint it on your paper, the color is going to turn out really light and hard to see. So add my food coloring, and now I have to add the flavoring. So you noticed in the blue we had the salt, in the green we had the citric acid. For the red, I'm going to go with sugar. And I'm going to add the sugar, and I'm going to keep adding and stirring until the sugar no longer dissolves. So all the sugar has dissolved in our little recipe of lickable watercolor right here, and I poured it from the pan into a glass. It's still a little warm. And remember, I can't see it, but I have sugar dissolved in my red food coloring. And this, I can dip my Q-tip in, and now I can paint the sun, and I get this beautiful red color. And I can't see the sugar because it's dissolved in the water, but something really cool happens once the water evaporates and my painting dries. So I painted parts of my picture. Now let's talk about the science at work in evaporation. You'll remember we had salt and blue food coloring for our ocean. We had citric acid and green food coloring, and I had sugar and red food coloring. Well, it's almost dry. All of that water evaporated off of my picture, and what was left behind? Well, I can see the blue coloring left behind, the green coloring left behind, and the red coloring left behind, but I wonder, could the salt and citric acid and sugar have been left behind? Well, I can't see it. I can't feel it. There's only one way to tell, and that's by licking. So I'm going to try and lick the ocean and see if it actually tastes salty. Here we go. It definitely has a salty taste to it. Let's see if I can get some sour from the citric acid. Yep, there's some sour there. I'm going to end on a sweet note with the red. I like ending with the sugar. Remember, if you want to try making your own lickable watercolors, don't use a dirty old paintbrush. Use something clean like a cotton swab that can be thrown away. If you want to use our diagram of the water cycle, we've attached it in the video description, or you can just draw your own picture. Science is so cool, especially when you can taste the fun. Thanks for watching.